I do it big, y'all. I ain't a ball of them. Bigger than beach balls. I'm knocking loaded. This is pure survival. Fame against my idols, Biggie and Michael. And ain't nobody talking, making any sense. Like people at the show still sitting in the stands. Get up. I bared it all like Proline. I ran it through the goal line and hit the goal mine. They tried to leave me out to dry, hanging from the clothesline. But watch me go with showtime. That's why I pay them no mind. Now let me know if we got what you need. Ticket you till you giggle. Baby, I keep it since I was simple and little. I scribble these riddles to spin your head like a swivel. I talk my way out of pickles. You're talking so superficial. We know it. We know it. I keep it hardcore like Pinecore. Luke against a Dark Lord like a Star Wars. I keep it sweating like Rick Ross. Flip flops. I took my life into my own hands like cross. Don't even try to correct me. Don't even try to understand and dissect me. And keep your mouth shut. You're talking too recklessly. I'm about to cut your line like a... Successfully, I did this domestically without any recipe and kept the integrity. I'm better than I ever been. I'm legend and a gentleman, pumping like adrenaline.
The game's future stars are on display as minor league baseball. Max Hamilton gets the call in game five of the series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, thanks, Matty V. This guy here is a basic three-pitch mix guy. Fastball, curveball, change, primarily fastball changeup guy. He'll use the curveball to effect, but one of the things he needs to do, locate his fastball to give himself a chance to use that good changeup and his curveball. Jumped all over that first pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss it. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
Stepping in now, Nate Orff.
The second baseman, number 70.
As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. Guys, we take a look at the home nine as they take the field tonight. They do come in fresh off a victory last time out, but they've been giving ground in the division of late. They've won just twice in their last seven games.
Yeah, Matty V. Hey, D-Row, talk about a team that's scuffling right now. I had a chance to talk to the manager before the game. He's not happy. The players aren't happy.
Yeah, and just a malaise has kind of come over this clubhouse. We had a chance, like you said, to walk through it a little bit. The boys are not jumping around. This is a big game today.
Digging in, Javier Gonzalez looking for better results than last night when he went 0 for 4 in that one. Ground ball left side. Scooped up on the backhand. And they won't have a play as he reaches it first. Let's see how this is scored. Ready now, Christian Cabrera. He drove in the other of their two runs last night.
Yeah, nobody on right there, Dan. Two outs. It's not every day you see a guy pick him up and put him down like him getting down to first base right there.
Meanwhile here, the throw down to second is not in time, and it's a stolen base.
Hey, you need a strikeout right here.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And this one's in the dirt. Good job there as the count goes to 1-2. 1-2. Here it is. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strikeout there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
And that's going to fall for a base hit. The run is in to score, and they take an early 1-0 lead.
Dan, you were one pitch away from getting out of this. Two outs, two strikes on the batter, and he's able to throw out a ribby knock.
D-Ro, it's hard to get more frustrated than that as a pitcher. You're one pitch away from getting out of a lot of traffic on the bases, getting into the inning, and next thing you know, you give up a two-out, two-strike base hit. Nothing more frustrating for a pitcher than to have that happen.
Outside, 2-1. The 2-2 left side. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. It's a run on two hits, one left. At the plate, Matthew Corley. He'll lead it off here to begin the second.
Matthew.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. Not close. It's 2-0. Now the 2-0 is laid off, but in there for strike one.
You know, Matty, I'll never understand this. You work so hard throughout the course of the season and course of this game to get in 1-0, 2-0, 3-1 counts. Guarantee yourself a fastball 80 to 90% of the time, and he takes it. Just can't understand the methodology there.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
This has not been a weekend to remember for him. He's just been completely lost at the plate, flailing all over the place. Now that's his sixth strikeout of the series. They've really got him figured out.
One down. The windup and the 0-1. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul.
Here we go, guys. Let's go.
Here's the 0-2. Saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Delgadio has a play, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Nothing across here this half of the... Stepping up now, Jimmy Ibarra. And he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow.
Jimmy Ibarra.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. That one's going to find the seats, strike one. Heading out towards shallow right. Vasquez is under it.
I go.
Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Digging in to try it again, Dylan Brignone. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Dylan.
And this is on the outside corner for strike one.
Expect the guy on the mound to keep attacking the zone right here. He has a chance for a quick inning. He is not nibbling. Everything is catching those 17 inches.
And that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances. Striding into the box, Nate Worf hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat. Swing and a liner. Foul.
Hey, here we go.
Runner's going. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Way late, and he's in there easily at second. Brignone, the runner at second with one away. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
The 2-2. Grounded down the third baseline. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full 3-2.
With the meat of the order due up next, you can probably expect to see something you can handle here with the full count as the two-hole hitter.
Here's the two-seam fastball that bears in a bit too tight. It's ball four. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number three. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2.
Good job of making him chase that pitch down below the strike zone. That's where you want to pitch when you're looking for the double play ball.
One ball and two strikes to count. And this is popped up near second base. Low is under it, two gone. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Christian Cabrera, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. 0-1 the count.
Hey, let's get out of this. Take the short one.
Down and away, ball one. And he goes the other way with it, high and deep down the left field line. And this one scoots all the way to the wall. One run will score easily. Here's the second runner around third. And he's in there safely as they take the lead with two runs scoring on the play.
With that base hit right there, D-Row, that's his third RBI of the game. Now, more importantly, his team's now ahead.
Yeah, these are the special ones. He's had a great approach all day. He's battled his tail off, and he's given his team single-handedly almost given his team a chance to win this one.
The pause and the 0-2. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Two out here and a runner at second. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Deerdorf will put this one away, and the side is retired. So it's two runs on two hits. No. So striding in, Matthew Corley, who looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. And a high strike there, 0-1.
We got nobody.
Ooh, I'm shocked he took that pitch right there. That ain't plus 90s right there. That's mid to low 90s fastball in the honey hole. I'm surprised he didn't pull the trigger on that one.
Now a ball lying toward the gap in left center. That's his first base hit, making one for two now. Settling in now, Robert Fitzgerald, 0-for-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop up foul.
Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. Oh, double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Jonas Carvajal. He flew out in his last at bat. A ball and no strikes. And I believe he broke the plane of the plate there. He most certainly did. It's a ball and a strike. The 1-1. Hit hard towards center. That gets down, and the inning continues. So the two-out base hit and the top of the inning is still alive.
Hey, D-Roll, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the two-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into their pen as quick as possible. And if two-out knocks are the answer, then so be it.
So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Working for the punch out and the offering. And another foul ball. Here's the 0-2. In the dirt here. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
Hey, come on, guys.
The 1-2 pitch. Grounder down the line at third. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Ball two.
Boy, the curveball just hasn't been there this afternoon. And this is this guy's bread and butter pitch, especially when he gets ahead of hitters. He needs to find that curveball again.
And that's going to get the job done. It's a base hit. And the run is in to score from second. It's 4-2. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Dylan Brignone. He singled his last time up. Takes this the other way to right. Vasquez will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Ready once again, Nate Orff. He'll start off the fifth in this one. First pitch of the at-bat. And that misses for ball one.
Here we go, guys. Hey, nobody out now.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. The 1-2. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Again, a 1-2. Change of speed there, but it's taken for a ball. 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. 3-2 pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're at
now time
lead.
Called here as the manager pops out of the first.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, here but the results sure speak for themselves.
8-2 tonight's Shuckers. Final. Eight the Shuckers led in. This game from no the third errors. Inning they on and never wavered. Jim McMullen.
Pitching coach checks in with a member of his staff.